What's up, everyone? It's Dima from the Bigglesworth server. I just wanted to make a video on soloing Flamelash. I saw a video from Tedj, basically trying to get the polearm off of him and saying he couldn't solo him, so I decided to give it a shot. And here's what happened. For those of you who haven't done a BRD farm, basically just run in, open the gate, skip a bunch of mobs, jump through the window like so, and jump past the door. I guess you can unlock it too if you want, but I usually kill that pad up there, but he was already leaving, so I decided to just run. Use your major or just regular invisibility pot to start with. Skip the mobs. I got kind of lucky here. There wasn't a lot of these little adds, just these two over on the left. So, judge justice, try to keep them away from other mobs, kill them quickly, just like that, and then you're going to encounter two of these flame elementals. They're somewhat difficult. I just judge crusader, fire aura, hopefully get some good RNG. I also ended up doing this with basically full buffs. Minus Onyxia and Dire Maul. Just normal raid buffs and the Dark Moon buff, Elixir of Giants. I got a Soul Stone and I got the Fire Festival buffs. So, this is honestly harder than the boss, I think. So, once you get past this, the rest is fairly easy. As you can see. Also, one thing to remember, I do have full tier 2 and a Bone Reaver's Edge. Ton of items. So I don't think just anyone could do this. Like, you probably have to be pretty geared, because I barely made it. So I mean, you can give it a shot, but if you don't have like tier 2 and stuff, it's probably not worth your time. So when you get to the Grim Guzzler, you have to run over to this vendor and you buy 6 of his drinks, turn him into this guy, he gets really drunk, and heads over to the kegs for a bit more. Once he does that, this door will open, and you can run through it before Phalanx comes over. That way you can just go on to the next part. It's good to have invisibility potions and lesser. Here I just use a lesser because the greater one's on cooldown. So getting the boss is fairly simple. And here I'm just kind of deciding which gear to use. I do have the skeleton book from Onyxia, so I'm going to use it. Because once you use it, you can actually buff him and then put on a weapon. And that way he's out and you're using a two-hander. So this just gives me a little bit of an edge on DPS. This is a brief overview of the gear I'm wearing. It's basically 5-piece Judgment, Don Julio's, Master Dragon Slayer Ring, Onyxia Tooth Pendant, Crown of Destruction, Wrist Guard's a True Flight. I did have to buy a Blazing Emblem for extra fire resist, so that's my first trinket, and my second trinket is Zandalarian Hero Charm. I also think I went with Therizane Link instead of Judgment Belt for a little bit extra crit, because if you don't do enough damage, you're just going to get wiped. So now the main thing you want to remember is the 2 greater fire resistance potions. You have to drink one, wait for it to cool down, and then you're going to drink another one during the fight. before I even engage, what I did was use the Greater Stone Shield potion, as you see. And then I waited for it to cool down to where it had 45 seconds remaining. And that's when I summoned my skeleton. So that way I'm starting off the fight with a Greater Fire Resist potion and a Greater Stone Shield on, hoping that I'm going to live long enough to use the second one after 45 seconds. So here I'm just comparing Therizane Link to Judgment Belt, and I decided to go with Therizane Link to have a little bit extra crit and attack power, plus it has more stamina, so I figured it'd be a better combo. So here it shows the potion has 45 seconds left on cooldown, so I summon my skeleton, give him might, switch to Bone Reavers. Start off by judging Crusader, hoping to get some extra damage. And I pop my Blazing Emblem right away, so I can try to preserve the first Greater Fire Protection potion. Switch to concentration, get the heal off, because all the adds there. Back to fire resist, use my trinket, luckily I get a crit there. Use consecrate, vengeance, and the trinket up. Checking my cooldowns, another consecrate. There's the second greater fire, another heal. And I'm using command and judgment of command. Basically the whole time. Switch to Judgment of Wisdom, because I have pretty low mana at this point. And then I pop Bubble and Bandage during it. And after this, since I have low mana, I decide to just top myself off with a couple of Flash Heals. Wisdom actually falls off here, but I get it reapplied. Luckily I had enough mana. And right here I use my Hellstone right there. And I basically wait for the last second to use Lay on Hands. Which is right there. Now it's pretty much in the bag. Hit him with the hammer. Switch to my one hand and shield, which is Malastar's Defender and Hakari Manslayer. One last hammer. And there you have it. Total cost of me was about 102 gold just to do this one run. That's because I bought Blazing Emblem for 80 gold just as a YOLO. But there you have it. Hope you guys enjoyed the video and have fun.